morning. My name is Sangeeta. I am from EEE department. Today I am going to discuss about a topic from electromagnetic field theory, that is force on a moving charge. So first we will go to force on a moving charge. And related to this, we will be deriving Lorentz force equation. So, how we can derive Lorentz force equation? So, let us consider first a stationary charge. Stationary charge. Or a moving charge, stationary charge or a moving charge Q in electric field. So whenever we studied about electric field intensity and charge, we learned one equation, that is F is equal to Q into E. That means if we place a stationary charge or a moving charge in an electric field, then existing force, that force is equal to F, which is equal to Q into E. That means the charge Q will be moving or accelerated in the direction of E due to the force F. So here in electrostatic, force is doing some work to move this charge Q in the direction or accelerated towards the direction of E. Then next we will consider a stationary charge in a magnetic field. So in order to derive Lorentz force equation, first we are considering a stationary charge or a moving charge Q in electric field. So whenever we are placing a charge in an electric field, we will have a force. That force F is equal to Q into E. We can say that the charge Q will be accelerated in the direction of E with the help of the force F. The next we are considering a stationary charge in a magnetic field. So whenever we are keeping a stationary charge in a magnetic field, there will not be any force acting on the charge. Whenever we are keeping a stationary charge in a magnetic field, there will not be any force. That means Fm is equal to 0. We are keeping a charge, stationary charge, in a magnetic field, then the force Fm will be equal to 0. That means it is not doing any work. Does not do any work. In previous case, we know that the charge is accelerating in the direction of electric field with the help of force. But if we keep the same charge Q in a magnetic field, Fm will be 0. That means that does not do any work. Next one, if we consider if the charge Q is moving with a velocity U. If the charge is moving with a velocity U in the magnetic field, then there exists a force which will be right angles to the velocity U. So this force is Fm. Once again, I repeat. If the charge is stationary and we are keeping the charge in the magnetic field, then force acting on the charge Fm will be equal to 0. That means the force is not doing any useful work. But if the charge Q is moving, moving with a velocity u, then there will be a force. That force will be F, which will be right angles to u. So we can write the equation Fm is equal to q into u cross B. Cross product Fm is equal to q into u cross B, or Fm is equal to q u B sine theta. We are taking the cross product. So Fm is equal to q into u cross B, or Fm is equal to q u B sine theta. Fm is equal to q u b sine theta. Now we have to make the Lorentz force equation. So what is actually Lorentz force equation? It is the combination, like if the charges experience the force due to electric field and the force due to magnetic field. So let us consider, if moving charge, Q is in the presence of both electric and magnetic field. So before going to Lorentz force equation, we should know why we are considering only the moving charge. So the reason is, if the charge is either stationary or it is moving, in case of electric field, we will get the force F is equal to qB. If the charge is either moving or it is stationary, in case of electric field, we will get F is equal to qE. But if the same stationary charge we are keeping in the magnetic field, Fm will be equal to C. Here we will have a force whether it is stationary or moving, but if the charge is stationary in the magnetic field, Fm will be equal to C. Then if the charge is moving with a velocity u, Fm is equal to q u b sine theta. So, in order to derive Lorentz force equation, we are considering the charge q is moving and it is in the presence of both electric and magnetic field. Therefore, the total force F will be equal to Fe, the force due to electric field, Fe plus Fm, Fe plus Fm. So F is equal to, we know that Fe is equal to q into E plus Fm is nothing but q into u cross B. So F is equal to q into E, or we can write this for qE plus qUB sine theta. So from the first equation, we can take as F is equal to q into E plus u cross B. So this is nothing but Lorentz force equation. So now, if we compare all the relationship, we can draw a table. Let us consider the charge. If the charge is stationary charge, under electric field, and under magnetic field, the charge is under electric field and under magnetic field, we are considering the stationary charge. So stationary charge Q, if it is under electric field, F is equal to Q into E. Whether the charge is moving or stationary, there will be a force, and that force F is equal to Q into E. But if the charge is stationary, Fm is equal to 0, there will not be any work. Then if the charge is a moving charge, the charge is moving with a velocity Q, F is equal to Q into E, F is equal to QE, then here Fm is equal to Q into U plus E. Then if the charge is under the influence of both electric field and magnetic field, the charge Q is under the influence of both the electric field and magnetic field, F is equal to Fp plus Fm, which is equal to Q into E plus U cross. This is nothing but Lorentz force equation. I hope it's clear for all. So this is applicable in machines, electrical machine side, and when it is come to generator as well as motor, we will be applying this equations. Now we will go to the other topic, that is magnetic flux. Magnetic flux, flux density, and it is related to flux linkage, etc. So based on this, we have to study the Maxwell's equations. So in EMF, Maxwell's equations are very important. In first unit, we will be studying about the Maxwell's equation related to electrostatics. Then Maxwell's third and fourth equation, we will be studying related to magnetism. So that is again related to magnetic flux. So magnetic flux linkage, psi we will be representing as N into phi. Magnetic flux linkage, psi is equal to N phi. And magnetic flux density, B is equal to flux per unit area, phi by N. Psi is equal to N phi. And magnetic flux density, B is equal to phi by A. That means Weber per meter square. The unit is Weber per meter square. Then how to derive the Maxwell's equation? So we have to consider the equation related to a closed surface. Then we can derive the Maxwell equation. That Maxwell equation is representing the non-existence of isolated magnetic force. So Maxwell equation are usually representing B dot ds equal to 0. So this is nothing but, it is representing the non-existence of isolated magnetic poles. So what is mean by isolated magnetic poles? So we know that if there is a magnet, there will be two poles, north pole and south pole, and we will get the flux lines like this. So here, if there is a north pole, definitely there will be a south pole. North pole alone, south pole alone, there will not be any existence. So this concept is related to Maxwell's equation, that is surface integral B dot ds equal to 0, which is representing the non-existence of isolated magnetic force. Similarly, in electrostatics, we were studying about the conservative nature, non-conservative nature of electric field. So conservative nature we are studying in first unit. When it is come to time varying field, it is non-conservative in nature. So next topic is Maxwell's equation.